I am fortunate to live in one of the most beautiful countries in Latin America, but in terms of technology, companies overvalue items, sometimes tripling the price. That's why I import from eBay, Amazon in the United States, but they take it to a P.O. box in Miami that transfers my packages. Upon arrival in my country, I also pay taxes and shipping. At least each package rises 30% of its real value. A good case can weigh up to 30 pounds, so it is not feasible to import it. You would pay at least twice its value just for transportation. That is why we must settle for cases, who sell in our country. Many of them outdated. I bought this ASA case, with RGB fans, and asked the store if it was compatible with an Asus gaming TUF to configure or a sync. But the surprise that I got when they delivered it to me, is that these cases bring fans with RRB connectors 5V 3-pin, and the Asus TUF X570 I have has 4-pin 12V connector, so it is not Aura Sync compatible, and a Chinese RGB control must be used to change colors. If you want to control the colors of the machine, like a real PC gaming with software, you will need a RGB converter 5V to 12V RGB and a transfer hub for RGB 3-pins to 4-pins. I buy this hub for my Asus motherboard. It also works for Gigabyte and MSI motherboards. In the box you will find the RGB transfer hub, an adhesive with Velcro, in case you want to permanently stick it in a place to your case, and a 3-pin to 212V converter connector on the hub. All this powered by the one SATA connector. The connectors are protected and also have a magnet inside, in case it is required to place it in a metallic part in the case without using the adhesive Velcro. I'm going to take advantage and place two LED strips in the case to synchronize both the RGB fans of the case and the LED strips. Also, I'll see how I delete the case mark, IMAD with them. Already off and without power, the first thing to do is identify where the 12V RGB connectors are on the motherboard. In the case of this X570 Asus Gaming TUF, has one on the top and one on the bottom. In the meantime, I want to get rid of those letters. The case itself only helps to place parts that you buy separately. And I was left with the lesson that you do not have to believe in sellers, at least what they sell in my country. Few have compatible cases in stores with Asus, MSI or Gigabyte that use 12V RGB 4-pin, but they triple the price. And here comes the tricky thing, the cable management. I'm going to take advantage and order a little. I have to untangle and find two connectors. The first thing to locate is the Chinese remote control that will no longer serve us. It's that fat cable. I suggest unplugging all the power ports from the fans and separating them. The most difficult decision is where to place the hub without looking at all the cables. Nobody likes a computer with messy cables. As I mentioned earlier, the great thing about this hub has a magnet to test the best place to place it. This must be decided before connecting any cables. Once we have identified the remote control cable and the 5V and 4-pin connectors of the case, we proceed to disconnect them all. The remote control cable of the RGB fans, as we will no longer use it, we discard it. We cascade all the 3-pin 5V RGB connectors, leaving only one to connect to the RGB hub. Once connected, we proceed to place the power to the RGB hub. We must tighten that cable very well. Then we identify an available SATA connector to give it power. In my case, I decided to connect the 12V 4-pin pin to the connector under my card and place the hub at the top, without affecting the possible places of SSD disks that I can buy and import. Let's locate the places where we can pass the cables without damaging them. First, the power cable of the RGB hub, then the 5V 3-pin connector that connects to the hub. We also connect the 12V and 4-pin cables, adjust them and leave them in the place we choose. Don't forget to reconnect the fans. You have to have good cable management for this. I recommend plastic tensioners and an exclusive nail clipper for your setup. I also got some 3D printed cable organizers that make it easy for you to hold them. The idea is that it is as neat as possible and that your cables, both in the front and in the back, look like professional cable ties. Once the back of your cables is organized, we proceed to close. In this setup, I will add a pair of LED strips to configure with Aura Sync. To place them in a better way, I have to open the upper part of the case. You can use a plastic nail, a flat screwdriver, and best of all, a putty knife. This does not damage the paint on the case, and it is much easier to apply pressure to remove the piece. Place the LED strips around your case, they bring glue, so it is extremely easy to stick it to the plastic or metal parts. Of course, you should buy those that are compatible with your RGB system. To remove the letters from the case they sold me, I simply put plastic in and painted with black spray paint. Then I smoked a cigarette and went back to I have her remove the plastic. I'm mad at this brand. If you are going to do this, it is under your responsibility, and you must make sure that you are not going to paint more than you should. With everything connected, it is time to close and connect the PC and do the litmus test. Turn on the equipment. As you see, the RGB fans now, they are synchronized with the Ryzen 7 3700X fan. They can all now be configured in ARMORY CREATE, which is the new Asus software that lets you do custom syncs. I wasn't very in love with RGB, but after this, I think I'll buy more RGB fans for the top. I think this transfer hub and volts for RGB is cheap and simple to fit. For all RGB loving gamers, it is not difficult to configure and does not require science but patience. So I hope I have helped several who have the problem that I had. Maybe because in your country, they have the same shortage of good PC cases at a good price, or because you got confused when buying it. But you know there is a solution for everything. Thank you very much. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to post them below in the video, subscribe and share. In the next video I'll show you how to sync my new RGB fans on the way.